The question which we are going to discuss today is a very much important question from the examination point of view. So it is the UPSC examination or it is the state civil service examination. It is very important question and it is the, you can say, hot topic of the day even. Seeing the China's aggression, seeing relations between India and China, which is not running smooth these days due to some border skirmishes or so. And similarly, rising association between China and Pakistan also. So in the, you can say, background of all these things, this topic becomes very much important. From your examination point of view, right? So the question which I gave you today, that is the discuss possible threats to India. Discuss possible threats to India. Possible threats to India from China's string of pearls policy. From China's string of pearls policy. That is our question. China's string of pearls policy. So this is our question. Right? So as far as this question is concerned, this question involves two key points. Right? One key point is China's string of pearls policy, which is one key point. And the second important key point in this is threats to India from this string of pearls policy. So these are the two important key points in this, right? So this is such a type of question where you are required to, you can say, explain the China's string of pearls policy also, though in brief. But that is required to be explained. And the second part is the possible threats to India from this string of pearls policy. Right? So this is the one thing, right? So next, the requirement of the answer includes, you can say, the requirement of the answer will include, the requirement of the answer will include, requirement of the answer will include one, China's string of pearls policy, which we will cover. China's string of pearls policy. This is the one important thing which is required to be covered in this question, in this answer, right? And the second important thing is that China India rivalry and China's growing relations, China's growing relations with India's all time enemy Pakistan, right? So this is the second, you can say, part of the question. And in your discussion somewhere, you must have to, you can say, bring it into focus that China's intentions are not always good, right? We must have to bring this also. Intentions are not always good. Are not always good. So this should, you can say, look through your, you can say, explanation somewhere. Are not always good. We need to show that also, right? And the next part will be security threats to India. Threats to India, we can say. The next part will be threats to India. Threats to India, right? And the next will be the conclusion of the, right? So, this part will be this these things we will need to cover in the, you can say, introductory part, right? So these things we will cover in the introductory part, and the main body of the answer should be this threat to India, because the question is related with this possible threat to India, right? And in the end, we need to conclude it, right? So this is the, we can say, requirement of this, we can say, you can say, answer, right? So in the light of this all, right, we will move further to, you can say, discuss the answer now, right? So main parts of the answer, if we say, this part of the answer is about the introduction, this part of the answer is about the, you can say, body of the answer means discussion, and this is about the conclusion. So main three parts of the answer are there, right? Mm-hmm. So beta, first of all, we need to understand, right? Is this clear to everybody that how to, you can say, right, break the whole job into the parts, right? So this is important because the analysis of the question is important, right? So this is important, right? So now we are moving to the next point, right? So first of all, I will try to explain, though I will try to explain in detail because I am to, you can say, teach you this topic also. You can adjust its length according to the requirement of the examination. Okay. So one thing is, we will, first of all, we will come on string of pearls, right? String of pearls, right? So if we see the string of pearls term, it includes the two words. One word is string, okay, and second word is pearls. Pearls moti, string mala. Right, so if we pearls here means the various pearls, pearl means the various pearls that are developed or being developed, that are developed or being developed or being developed by China. Being developed by China, right? There in South China Sea and Indian Ocean region, right? So this we will say the string. Sorry, this is the pearls. This is what we mean by the pearls, right? So this is important thing. And now the word string means, string here means the connectivity of those ports, right? String here means the connectivity of those ports. Connectivity of those ports, right? So it means the term string of pearls means, what do we mean by the term string of pearl means, right? So string of pearls, right, are the various ports, are the various ports, and we can say military bases, right? Military bases, various port facilities, you can say, and the military bases in countries bordering, right? In countries bordering South China Sea, and we can say Indian Ocean, right? So we will modify this definition later on. Okay, this is just a basic thing which I'm going to tell you, right? So beta, it means a string of pearl are the various ports, right, and military bases in countries bordering South China Sea and the Indian Ocean, right? So this is in brief what we mean by the string of pearls here, right? So I would like to show you the, you can say, how the, you can say, string is being made, right? I would like to show you here. So as far as the beta string is concerned, you can see that here. Is it visible to you? I think not, na?
No, sir, not visible.
Yes, I know. First of all, I must have to share you this, you can say, desktop. Then it will become visible. Now it becomes, is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So beta, this is what we mean by this, you can say, string of pulse, right? This is what we mean by this string of pulse, right? So this from Hong Kong, this South China Sea, this Cambodia, here this Myanmar, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Pakistan, Gwadar, and then here Port Sudan, right? So this becomes like a string, right? And these red spots are called the pearls in this string, right? So this is what we mean by the string of pearls policy of China, right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will come again on this, you can say, thing, right? So we will do later on. Right, so this is basically there. Right, so we will do it later on also. Right, so is it okay, beta? So now I am coming to the, you can say, next point. Okay. I will zoom it in. See here. Are you seeing it now?
Yes, sir.
Hong Kong, right? You can say this South China Sea, right? And South China Sea again Gulf of Thailand, this Andaman Sea, this is, you can say, Myanmar, this is in, you can say, this is in the open door, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Maldives, Pakistan, right? And here is the Port Sudan, right? And now recently one more country has been added to it, that is the Iran also, right? So we will discuss that again. Okay, so now I'm going to discuss the next, you can say, in this lecture, right? So the next thing which is in this lecture is, that is, you can say, beta, yes. The next thing in this lecture which we are going to discuss. So I have shown you the pearls, right? String of pearls. That is called the string of pearls, right? So now, beta, after seeing the, you can say, string of pearls, one thing is clear, that you can say, the main concentration of the Chinese pearls, that is bordering India. Okay, you can say the main concentration of those ports, that is around the India, right? So let us, you can say, modify this definition now further. We will write here that string of pearls are the various ports, right? Are the various ports and military bases
Screen is not visible.
Okay, screen is okay. This is not visible. Okay, I'm reading. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, string of pearls are the various ports and military bases in countries bordering South China Sea, and Indian Ocean in general, right? And we can say India in particular. Right? So, because China is doing this under a well thought program, that is why the spreading of ports in Indian Ocean region and South China Sea with the purpose of increasing Chinese influence, right? With the purpose of increasing Chinese influence is called a string of pearls policy, because this is the policy of China, string of pearls policy, right? So firstly, we discussed about the string of pearls, that what is string of pearls, and now we have moved on to the string of pearls policy, right? For examination, you can say, write about the string of pearls policy only, right? There is no need to mention the first thing, because that was to just to make it clear for you, right? So beta, now let us you can say visit that you can say part again. This is there, right? So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? And if we include the, you can say, Iran also in this, you can say 8, 9 ports are there, which are around, you can say, India only, right? And beta, beyond India, there are only 4, 5 ports which are developed by the China, which are being developed by the China. So beta, that is why the, you can say, experts say that the string of pearls policy of China is focused mainly on the, you can say, India, because India in Southeast Asian region is the only influential country, okay, which is sitting on the, you can say, which is sitting above the Indian Ocean, sitting on the head of the Indian Ocean, we can say, right? So that is why, and moreover, China and India have some, you can say, disputes, rivalry since decades, because there are territorial disputes between China and India. And moreover, you can say India's, you can say, increasing association with the US also is one of the reasons, you can say, right? So due to which the China is, you can say, the cordoning of you can say India there, right? So beta, these are the important things, right? So this is important, which you must notice or which you must keep in your mind, right? So these are the various important things here. Okay. So the next thing is that, right? So this is there, right? So now we will, is it clear, beta? Is it clear up to this point?
Yes.
Okay, beta. So now, beta, right now I am coming on to the again our screen only, right? So beta, now we will write about this introduction part, right? Before writing the introduction, let us discuss more about the, you can say, string of pearls first, right? And then we will write it further. So first of all, the important thing is that the various ports, the various, you can say, ports developed or are being developed by China. This is important for your preliminary examination, are being developed by China, right? Under its string of pearls policy, under its string of pearls policy. So one thing we will discuss this, right? Ports and military bases, you can say, right? The various ports and military bases developed or are being developed by China under its string of pearls policy. So this is the, right? So I would like to tell you the list of those, you can say, ports also, right? Number one is we can say Hong Kong. It's in Hong Kong. I will show it to you. Right, number one is in Hong Kong. Right, so as far as the Hong Kong is concerned, one second. Sure. So, beta, as far as this, we can say Hong Kong is concerned, right? So, Hong Kong. So, let me write it here. Right, Sanya. Sanya is the name of the port which is being developed there in Hong Kong. In Hong Kong. Hong Kong. Right? And it is in the, you can say, Hainan Island. Hainan Island of the Hong Kong, where this facility is being created and developed. So, beta, this is where, this is in the South China Sea. This is being developed in South China Sea. So ये साउथ चाइना सी में डेवलप हो राइट सानिया सो यू कैन से कि इट इज दिस पॉइंट राइट इट इज दिस पॉइंट वी कैन से हियर राइट बेटा राइट एंड सेकंड इज बेटा यू कैन से वुडी आइलैंड सेकंड इज हियर दैट इज द वुडी आइलैंड लेट मी राइट इट हियर Woody Island, right? Woody Island is again South China Sea. Woody Island is again South China Sea, right? South China Sea. And it is a disputed territory. And it is a disputed territory. It has somebody's mic is on, please, off it. South China Sea. It is a disputed territory. It's a disputed territory, you can say, among the three countries, that is China, Vietnam, and Taiwan. So it is disputed territory there. Right? So Woody Island, right? So we can say, we can take it like this, like here. Right? So this territory is there, right? This territory is there, right? And the next point is we can say Spratly Islands, Spratly, Spratly Islands, Spratly Islands, right? Spratly Islands. This is basically, and we can say archipelago. Archipelago means a group of islands in South China Sea. In South China Sea, right, which is claimed by, you can say, Philippines also, right? So this is again, we can say, disputed territory, right? So you can say on this Spratly Island, you can say some of the facilities have been developed by China, right? So on the pretext of this, we can say that it is for the security of the maritime routes, right? And later on, China has started building its military bases over there, right? And this is there. And the next one is, we can say, the next one is, we can say, Sihanouk Vilu, Sihanouk Vilu, Sihanouk Vilu, right? Sihanouk Vilu. This is in Cambodia. Sihanouk Vilu is in Cambodia, right? So this port has been actually, this place has been actually virtually taken over by China, you can say, right? So it is you can say this part, it is this part, right? It is this part, right? And the next is, are you getting it, Beta?
Yes, sir.
And the next is, Pita, you can say Coco Islands of Myanmar, right? In Bay of Bengal region, right? So that is the Coco Islands of Myanmar in Bay of Bengal region. So this is that part, Pita, Coco Islands part. Near the Andaman and Nicobar, very close to Andaman and Nicobar, you can see. Right? And at the next one is Beta. That is the, right? That is the Kyukphu. Kyukphu. You can say Y. Isko PH bhi likh dete hain, single B bhi likh dete hain. Kyukphu of Myanmar. Of Myanmar, right? So this is again in Bay of Bengal region, right? And from this region, you can say Kyukphu port, right? From this Kyukphu port, there is a road link also from Kyukphu to Kunming of China, right? There is a road link also from, you can say, Kyukphu to Kunming of China, right? So a road link has been established, right? Kunming.
Right? Kyukphu to?
This project is under consideration. Kyukphu. What are...
from Kyukphu to?
Pardon? Kyukphu?
Road connectivity Kyukphu to, sir, China de vich kehdi jagah?
Kunming. I have written
Kunming. Okay.
Kunming, right? So this is there, and the next port is that is this Chittagong in Bangladesh, right? Chittagong in Bangladesh. Right, this is also in Bay of Bengal region, right? This is also in Bay of Bengal region, Beta, this point I will explain later, right? So I have, you can say, dropped it consciously so far, right? So I'm going to explain it later on. So Chittagong in Bangladesh in Bay of Bengal region, right? So is it okay? So the next port which is there, that is, we can say, in Sri Lanka. This is a Hambantota, right? Sri Lanka, it is Hambantota. right? Sri Lanka. It is in Indian Ocean. Okay, Hambantota. Right, in Sri Lanka. In Indian Ocean region. In Indian Ocean, right? So this is another, you can say, port, right? And beta, Hambantota, what happened here in the Hambantota? Sri Lanka developed this port as a commercial port, but the cost of this port was so high that you can say Sri Lanka was not able to repay the cost which was incurred by China there. So later on, China, you can say, forced Sri Lanka, right, to give this port to it on lease to develop a military base over there, right? So this is the strategy of China, right? That first it enter into a country, right? Okay, understand. That first it enters into a country, right? Sign a memorandum of understanding, you can say, with those countries, right? And do the huge investments there, right? And when the countries are not able to, you can say, repay the money invested by the China, so then China started forcing on them to give that port to China on lease. And once China takes it on lease, then you can say, China start developing the military bases over there. So this has happened with this Hambantota port. And it is probable, most probable, that you can say with the rest of the countries, perhaps shall also, you can say, the same thing will happen, because this is China's, you can say, conscious plan, conscious, you can say, strategy, right, to make huge investments into the country. Okay? Debt trap policy, China's. Yeah, this is part of China's debt trap policy. Right, I'm coming to the point. Right, so yes, actually, China has started using it for, you can say, these purposes. Okay, so you can say China's submarine also visited here, Hambantota, you can say, a few years back, and so such things are already happening there, right? So, beta, the next one port. I'm coming to your question, Nishank. Akshaj, beta, I have answered your question, right? So this is another port in Maldives. And this port is, you can say, Marao port, right? Marao, M-A-R-A-O. Marao in Maldives, right? Marao in Maldives. This is in the, we can say, again, in the Indian Ocean. In Indian Ocean. Right, but very close to India, you say. This is also very close to India. 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 Right. So, Marao in Maldives. And the next port is the most, you can say, in news. That is the Gawadar port in Pakistan. Right. Gawadar port in Pakistan, which is connected with China through the CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, Gawadar port in Pakistan. That is there, right? Gawadar port in Pakistan, which is being connected with China through the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, CPEC, which is known as this, right? So it runs like this, okay? China's Xinjiang province, Xinjiang, X-I-N-J-I-A-N-G, Xinjiang province of China, right? Province of China is connected to this port. China is connected to this port. Connected to this port via CPEC. Via CPEC, which runs through the you can say, Pakistan occupied Kashmir. Okay, the territory which has been illegally occupied by Pakistan according to Indian, you can say, records, right? So that is there through the POP, right? And the problem is that while you can say constructing the CPEC, which runs through the Pakistan occupied Kashmir, which is the territory which is, you can say, claimed by the India, China even did not consult India. China even did not bother to sought any type of permission from India even. Because China knows that, you can say, this territory is claimed by, you can say, India also, right? So, right, so the next thing is that there is a, you can say, port, after that, the next port I will like to tell you, there is, you can say, the port, this is the Port Sudan, right, Port Sudan. Port Sudan is on Red Sea. Right? Port Sudan is on Red Sea. Port Sudan. In Sudan country, on Red Sea. Right? On Red Sea. This is on Red Sea. Okay. The, apart from that, the recently, you can say, few days back, right, China has entered into an agreement in an understanding, a strategic partnership with, you can say, Iran, right? According to that strategic partnership, right, China has been given, you can say, access to this port, and China will invest to expand this port in, you can say, Iran. Right, this port is very strategical port. So this is Port Jask. Port Jask in Iran. Right? According to the July 2020, right? Entered into between Iran and China. Entered into between Iran and China, right? Port Jask. And beta, apart from that, there is a one, you can say, one free trade zone China will develop in, you can say, northwestern part of the country, Iran. Let us take it here, for example, right? So this will be a free trade zone which will be developed by China in, you can say, Iran. China will invest there. And this free trade zone is located at, you can say, Maku, M-A-K-U, Maku in, you can say, Iran, northwestern Iran. So this is there according to this strategic partnership only, right? And next is one more important point where this river Shital Arab, you can say, falls into this Persian Gulf, right? At this point, right? Iran will, China will develop another port, you can say, in this country, Iran. Okay, and the name of that port is, we can say, name of that port is, you can say, Abadan port, A-B-A-D-A-N, Abadan, right? Abadan, right? And next, there is one more, you can say, island in the Gulf, which is, you can say, almost here, right? So this island is known as Qasim Island. So here also, China will invest, right? Here also China will invest. So this is called Qesham, Q-E-S-H-M, Qesham Island, right? So here also China will invest, Qesham Island, right? So beta, this is the China's string of pearls you are seeing, right? How China is, you can say, cordoning of India and how China is increasing its, you can say, influence, surveillance into the, you can say, Indian Ocean region, right, which was once dominated by India, USA, and other forces also, right? And now China has started increasing its, you can say, influence and see how much investment China is doing in this region, right? So this is there. Yes, Peter, Maku, Abadan, and Kashim and Keshim, all will be the free trade zones. Abadan habitat, A-B-D-A-N, right? Abadan, right? So all these will be the free trade zones which are being developed by this China. Right, Kosimran? Yes, what is your question? Hello?
Sir, China ni Africa de vich vi adde idhar hage age oh ni sir string of pearl policy chaunde jithe idhar unna ne kiti investment.
Beta, those are there. There is one port in Kenya also, right? And Maldives also, right? Those are there, right? So, but I have skipped those mainly. And here is one country. This country is a, what is the name of this country? Can anybody tell? African country, what is the name of this country? Djibouti, Djibouti, right? So here in this country, yes, Peter. So here in this country, you can say there was some internet issue. So here in this country, which we were talking about, right? So everything has gone. So here in this country, China China has developed its naval base, right? Here, China has developed its naval base. Right, so this is the Djibouti where China has developed its navy, right? Right, so Peter, these are the various you can say, right, ports which are under development or which have been developed, some of which have been developed by China, right? So you see how the China is increasing its, you can say, influence by making the billions of dollars of investments in various countries, right? Now, let me take the Nishank's question. So the Nishank's question was that why do countries, you can say, allow China to, you can say, come in and, you can say, invest in their port facilities? That is the Nishank's question. Subita, the various countries which are, you can say, looking for, you can say, investment, right? Which are looking for investments, right? So, to, you can say, accelerate their economic growth, to, you can say, to create employment in their country and to make themselves economically stronger, because these countries, Pakistan, Maldives, Myanmar, Bangladesh, these countries don't have the, you can say, capital resources. So that is why they are looking for the, you can say, foreign investments, right? So China enter there, right? And you can say, exercise its debt trap policy. And then after that, slowly, slowly, China, you can say, start increasing its, you can say, influence there. Nishank, is it clear, beta? Hello?
Yes, sir, absolutely.
Okay. Now there is one question from, you can say, Akshaj, that the question is that what does China invest in the free trade zone? On what, right? So, because in free trade zones, China develops the ports, China develops the, you can say, infrastructure there, right? dry ports are also developed, right? And then you can say, if it is on the port facility, then you can say the port will be developed, right? Port, warehouses, you can say storing facilities, and all these things are being developed there, right? And then you can say infrastructure also, road connectivity, rail connectivity. So beta, all these things are required to be developed, right? So Akshay, clear beta? So beta, the next important point which Akshay, you can say, asked from me is this point, right? Is this point. This point is known as this, you can say. Akshay beta, are you clear? So this point is known as beta Kara Canal. Kara, K-R-A, Kara Canal, right? Okay, beta, Kara Canal, which is known as the Thai Canal also. Which is known as the Thai Canal also, right? And China is very much enthusiastic to, you can say, invest money into this project, right? Because the point is that here is very narrow isthmus, right? And you can say this canal project will connect Andaman Sea with the Andaman Sea with the Gulf of Thailand, right? Andaman Sea with the Gulf of Thailand, right? Andaman Sea with the Gulf of Thailand. So this canal project will connect Andaman Sea with the Gulf of Thailand, right? So beta, here it is the Andaman Sea. In this region, you can say, in this region, here is the Andaman Sea, right? In this region. And here is the Gulf of Thailand, right? And a canal through this route, you can say, canal through this route will join this Andaman Sea with the Gulf of Thailand, right? So this is the next project in pipeline. The negotiations are on. China has, you can say, thrown its proposal before the Thailand, and hope that this project will also get mature, right? So this is the this is about the string of pearls there, right? So beta, now what is important from the Indian point of view, which is the requirement of the answer, which is to be discussed here. First of all, if we see that there are two, three important points which are required to be, you can say, discussed here, right? Number one, India and China have decades old rivalry, right? There are territorial, you can say, issues which are lying pending between India and China. And both the countries have fought a war in 1962 also. And after that, you can say, various border skirmishes, you can say, happen between Chinese forces and Indian forces quite often, right? And the very recent is in the Galwan Valley, right? So this is there. One is that. And second point is China's association with Pakistan is growing, because CPEC is a multi-billion dollar project in which the China has, done the capital investment, and similarly, Gawadar port is a very huge project which has been undertaken by China, right? And the growing association between, you can say, Pakistan and China, that is also very serious concern for India, because India has pending territorial issues with both the countries, with Pakistan as well as, and with China also, right? So beta, that is why this concern is taken very much seriously, right? So one thing is that. And second thing, if we see that the intentions of China are not good, right? As we have seen that how China entered into Sri Lanka on the pretext of development of a commercial port, right? And after that, China started forcing Sri Lanka to, you can say, to use that port to make a military base over there, right? and similarly you can say in South China Sea, okay, we are seeing that you can say that China is too much aggressive there, right? How China has captured the territories there in the South China Sea, right, which are not legal according to the UNCLOS, right, which is UN treaty hai, right, open seas ke upar. So that is also not fair according to that treaty, right? And the next thing is that you can say how China is playing anti-US card, right? US has imposed sanctions on this country, Iran, right? Iran was in financial trouble because oil was not being supplied. And that is why China has entered into the fray, and China has offered, billions of dollars of investment here in the country, right? And with that investment, China will be able to increase its influence in the Persian Gulf region also. So Persian Gulf region is the main source of, energy. It is the biggest energy supplier to the world, right? So China has jumped there also. Right, and moreover, we see that various strategic points. This is strategic point, because from these points, China can keep watch and surveillance over the entire activities of Indian Ocean region. Right, from this point, China can keep watch on the activities in the Arabian Sea region. Right, and from these Jasek port and Abadan port, etc., and Keshan port, China will be able to keep watch on the activities happening of the Gulf of Oman and the Persian Gulf region, right? And moreover, Strait of Hormuz is a very important choking point of this region, and China has entered China has taken this port from Iran, which is called the Jasek port. China will do investment in this port. This is just before the entry into the Strait of Hormuz. This is very strategical point, right? And similarly, Kara Canal, right? Kara Canal is very close to Andaman and Nicobar and the eastern borders of India. This Koko Island is also very close to Andaman and Nicobar and the eastern borders of India, right? Kyokfu is also very close to, northeast of India and the eastern borders of India. And this Chittagong is also very close to this. And this is very close to the south, southern part of India. This is also close to the southern part of India. And that is the thing, huh? And this naval base, right, is also important, to capture the Indian Ocean anytime, right? To increase its movement, surveillance, spying into this region of Indian Ocean. And the port Sudan is again a very strategic point because almost entire traffic from the Eastern America, Europe, and Northern Africa, and this Saudi Arabia, etc., goes through the Red Sea towards the Asia, right? And and here are some big countries. China is big country, India is big country, and South Korea is a big economy, right? Japan is also there, Singapore is also there, and these are the very big economies, right, in terms of the volume of trade and in terms of the value of trade also. So with that, trade with the entire Europe happens through the Red Sea region, and China is sitting here. So with that is why China is moving forward very strategically. And moreover, the important choking points. Okay, China is sitting near the important choke points into the sea, right? One important choke point is here. What is its name, beta? Strait of Bab el-Mandeb, right? So what is its name? Its name is Strait of Bab el-Mandeb, right? Please remember, so, right? Strait of Bab el-Mandeb. This is its name. Okay? So this strait connects the Red Sea with the Gulf of, you can say, Aden, right? So this is this strait, right? Or Red Sea with Indian Ocean, you can say. That will also not be wrong, right? And now you can say another important choking point is here, Strait of Hormuz, right? Strait of Hormuz connects the Persian Gulf with the, you can say, Indian Ocean, right? So that is also important point, right? Where this is, where it is sitting, right? And the third important choke point, which is in this region of the, you can say, Indian Ocean. That third important choke point, Peter, is here. This choke point is the Strait of Malacca. Third important choke point is here, which is known as Strait of Malacca, right? Here, this part, northern part is known as the Malay Peninsula, and the southern part, this part is called the Sumatra Island of Indonesia, right? Sumatra Island of Indonesia. Yes, Gursimran, what do you want to ask?
No, sir. Pehlan da, sir.
Okay. So, beta, this is there, right? So, this is known as Strait of Malacca. Are you getting, beta? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. Sir, please tell about
the second one.
Pardon?
Please tell about the second one, middle
yes.
one.
Yes, yes, I am telling. This is called the Strait of Malacca. Malacca, right, is between Malay Peninsula, Malay, Malay Peninsula, right, and Sumatra, right, Sumatra Island of Indonesia. And the strait connects South China Sea with Indian Ocean, right? South China Sea with Indian Ocean, right? And Peter, the you can say about 80% of China's energy supplies. And a very huge trade of China passes through this, you can say, Strait of Malacca. Right? 80% of China's energy supplies. So now this is an important thing, Peter. You must focus on this. 80% of China's energy supply and very huge trade of China. Very huge. You can say maritime trade of China, right? passes through this very narrow Strait of Malacca, this very narrow Strait of Malacca, right? So this is important, right? Because of energy. You can say oil and gas comes from this region, oil, right? And from this region, it enters into the Arabian Sea. From Arabian Sea via Indian Ocean, it enters into the South China Sea and then it reaches China, right? Energy supply, beta means supply of the oil, supply of the gas also, right? Crude oil, gas. That is what we mean by the energy supply, right? So, this is there. Is it clear, beta, to you? So 80% of China's energy supply passes through this region, right? And you know, Chinese economy is a very growing economy, right? And China is a fuel hungry country, right? China is a energy hungry country, we can say. Energy hungry country, right? Seeing its economic development and all. So energy is the most important resource for China, right? Energy is the most, वैसे तो ये सभी economies के लिए होता है, right? energy is the most important resource for Chinese economy. Right? So there is need to see that how China is moving the cards very strategically. Right? So this is important to understand it from this thing. Right? How you can say India is becoming loser in this game, and how China is, you can say gaining edge over India, trying to gain edge over India in this game. Right? So this is important to know. Shubhita, actually the main thing is that this Strait of Malacca is under the control of USA. This Strait of Malacca is under the control of US, because the US Navy is staying here. Okay, seeing the importance of this sea route. All right, that you can say if this sea route is blocked, then almost the entire trade with this Eastern Asian region will be affected. Right? Southeastern Asian region will be affected. Right? So this is under this. Is it clear up to this point, Peta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Peta. So sir, now the
next or question bhi aaya, sir.
Yes.
Sir, jidda China ne inniyan jyada ports banaiyan, sir, US diyan nahi jyada ports. Why only China is making?
But China is becoming
so many ports. Aggressive.
China is becoming too much aggressive, right? So US is also, okay, you can say, running according to its own strategy. Not an issue, right? But we are talking about China here.
Yes.
So, beta, one thing is this. I think this is clear to you that this is under the control of the Chinese Navy, right? Chinese Navy is staying here permanently in the Strait of Malacca. And the next thing is, beta, India has strategic advantage. India has strategic advantage over China, right? India has strategic advantage over China in Strait of Malacca region. Okay, so India has strategic advantage over China in the Strait of Malacca region. How this, you can say, strategic advantage is there? Number one, India's friendship with the US. Okay, and this port is and this strait is under US control, right? Friendship with the US. This is the one point, right? And the second important point is that you can say in 2018, India has entered into an understanding with Indonesia. You can say to develop a port there, deep sea port, which is the Sabang port. Right? India has entered into an agreement with Indonesia to develop the Sabang port. Right, so beta, Sabang port, will be situated at this point, very close to the Strait of Malacca. Right, so Sabang port, right, and beta, apart from that, you can say beta. Singapore has also given access to Indian Navy of its, naval base. Singapore has also given access to Indian Navy of its naval port, which is the Changi port. right? Chandni port. So Indian Navy can use that Chandni port, right? According to an understanding with Singapore, Chandni port, right? So that is another, you can say, important point, right? Chandni port. Is it clear up to this point, right? And the next,
yes, sir.
Yes, and the next important point is that that you can say India is having a naval base. India is having a naval base in, you can say, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Right? So with India's strategic advantage is that these four points are very much important, which you should remember, that how India's strategic advantage is there over China in this region of Strait of Malacca, right? Number one, we have taken that this is under the control of US, because US Navy is being there permanently. And you can see India has good relations with the US, and China's relations with the US are not cordial. And that is why, if you can say the problem occurs there, then US will definitely help India, not China. This is the one point. And second is Peter Sabang Port. Sabang Port is very near to, you can say, Strait of Malacca, right? If India sits there in this, you can say, right, at the Sabang Port region, so then obviously that will be an advantage of India, advantage for India, right? And the third is, here it is Singapore, right? And Changi Port access has been given by Singapore to, you can say, Indian Navy. Right, so we can use that port. And next, Andaman and Nicobar is very close to this, the Strait of Malacca, right? In case of any problem, you can say, in case of any, you can say, emergency, Indian, you can say, naval forces, and you can say, fighter jets of the, you can say, Indian Air Force can immediately reach at this point, right? So China is far away, so it will, you can say, take time for China to reach there. Beta, China is very much willing to, you can say, do everything here, right? But due to the US presence here, okay, China is not able to do in this Strait of Malacca region, right? So beta, so now the beta thing is that, Akshay, clear beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now beta, the point is that now the important number one point, number two point, number three point, number four point. And due to beta, all these four, you can say, points, sir, India has strategic advantage over China, right? In the Strait of Malacca region, right? And beta, as we have already discussed here, that you can say, as we have already discussed, that you can say China's 80% energy supplies pass through this, you can say, Strait of Malacca. And Chinese economy, you can say, is a, you can say, energy hungry economy, right? So so beta, that is why, right? So China, it was strategically important for China. It was strategically important for China. It was strategically important for China in the long run, right? To come out of Malacca dilemma. Because due to the Malacca issue, China was not in position to, in, you can say, good negotiation capacity on the territorial issues with India. The reason being, if the problem, you can say, rises beyond a certain extent, you can say, if the problem rises to war level between India and China, then you can say India and the US, right, are in position to choke this Strait of Malacca. And if this Strait of Malacca is choked, then you can say we can say energy supplies to this region will be cut off. Is it clear, beta? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So beta, this problem this problem, which is known as the Malacca dilemma for China, this problem always has kept China within its, you can say, limitations, within its boundaries, right? Within its limitations. So beta, it prevents China from becoming too much aggressive, right? Because there is the Malacca issue for China, right? And beta, so beta, that was very much important for China to, you can say, antidote India's strategic advantage there. To antidote India's strategic advantage there. That was important for China. To antidote India's strategic advantage there. Right? And for that, beta, what China is doing or beta has done, right? Number one, Kavadar. Right? Number one, Kavadar. Right? China don't need anything now. Right? What will happen, beta? Oil supply will come from this Gulf region to Gwadar, and from Gwadar via land route, it will enter into China. This is the one thing. Right? Clear? And the second point is, right? And the second point is, beta, that now this Kyakfu port is there, right? From this Kyakfu, beta, by land route, right, China will trade, right? So no need to, you can say, pass through the Strait of Malacca for Chinese ships, right? And third is that China is focusing on this Kara Canal, right? If the Kara Canal project gets mature, in that case, what will happen, beta? So Strait of Malacca will be totally cut off, right? Chinese ships will not need to enter this, you can say, Strait of Malacca, right? And this Kara Strait will be under the control of China because China will invest in this, right? And from Indian Ocean, this Kara Canal, Thai Canal, into South China Sea, and China will, you can say, bypass this entire Strait of Malacca. So these are the three moves to antidote India's strategic advantage there, right? And the fourth move, which China has you can say exercised in this month of July 2020, and that beta fourth move is China's, you can say, strategic, right? China's beta strategic entry into the Persian Gulf region, into the Persian Gulf region, right, beta? So beta, right, if US and India would try to harm, right, China's interests by blocking this Strait of Malacca, then China in the long run, in the years to come, would be in position to block the oil supplies from here. Right? China is sitting in the Persian Gulf region. China is sitting exactly before the entry point of the Strait of the Hormuz, right? And beta, so beta, this is the basically strategy, right, which the China has exercised, is exercising to, you can say, counterdote this, right? Antidote this or to come out of the Malacca dilemma. Is it clear, beta, up to this point? Hello? Yes.
Please, first point, Gwadar port wala ek bari repeat kar do.
Yes. Beta, see, Gwadar port has been developed by China, right? Right, and beta, now what will happen, beta? China, right? China need not to pass through this, you can say, Malacca Strait. China need not to depend on this Malacca Strait for its energy needs, right? From the Gulf region, right? Energy supply will come to Gwadar port, and from Gwadar port through the land route, right? CPEC. And from that route, beta, it will enter into China. So China need not to depend on this Strait of Malacca for its energy supplies and trade. Clear point?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Right. So beta, this is basically strategy of China, right? So one threat is this, that you can say, this Malacca dilemma, which was, preventing the China from becoming too much aggressive right, which was preventing China from becoming too much aggressive, and which was essential to keep China within its limits. Right now, beta, China is, you can say, trying to come off this Malacca dilemma. Right, when China completely comes out this Malacca dilemma, at that time, you can say, India's security will be affected, right? Because China will be having lesser threat from Indian from India as compared to today. Because today, due to the Strait of Malacca region, right, China prevents from becoming too much aggressive on India, because in that case, India can affect its energy supply and can affect its trade also, because India has strategic, you can say, advantage over China in the Strait of Malacca, right? So one point is this, beta. And the second important point is beta, the alternative routes, the routes which are alternative to the Strait of Malacca will definitely increase, beta, China's negotiation power. So whenever India and China will sit, resolve their territorial disputes, so because China will become more demanding in that case, right? Because China will be having no Malacca dilemma on that day. So that is the another threat, right, which we are facing today. Right, which fourth point, beta? Akshaj, which fourth point? Yes, beta, antidoting means to counter the India's, you can say, influence over the Strait of Malacca. China is trying to develop alternative routes. One route is presently operational, which is the CPEC and Kavadar port. Right? So, beta, China need not to depend on, you can say, Strait of Malacca in that case. Right? In that case. So, one is this. Second is this. Right? So, beta, third is this Thai Canal, and fourth is this. Right? When China will be sitting here, in this beta Persian Gulf region, in that case, beta, this is the major energy supplier region. Okay, this is the major energy supplier region. When China will be sitting here, right, so beta, it can block the energy supply, right, fuel supply to, you can say, oil supply to, you can say, India as well, right? It would not allow Indian ships to pass through that region, right, beta? If we will try to purchase oil from the Saudi Arabia, and we will try to move our ships, you can say, via this route, via Red Sea route, because there again China is sitting on the port stern, and beta, here also Djibouti also. Beta, in case of war, right, China will become in position to cut the oil supplies of India, right? So beta, that is the point, that how China has. China is trying to counter, you can say, India's effect, right? And the second, right? And the second, this is the one point, right? And the second is that China will be in better negotiation power in that case, right? So this is the one. And the second point is that, yes, Simran, what do you want to ask? Hello? Simran, your voice is not coming. Your voice is not coming, Simran.
Hello, sir.
Yes,
now it
yes.
is coming.
Yes.
Sir, instead of these war situations, otherwise China can interfere in the normal, means this shipping or whatsoever, commercial or whatsoever.
China activities. Yes. China will be in better bargaining power in that case, right? So any issue, any point arises, right? China will definitely be in advantage, right?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, so obviously, anytime. So this is the point, right? And the next important point is that the second we can say important security threat to India, that is in the form of the surveillance, spying, and India's and Indian forces movement. So that is the next important point, right? Surveillance, spying, and movement of Indian forces in the region. Right. So that is the next important point. Right. So, beta, in this point, we will mainly discuss that China's increased presence in this Indian Ocean region will definitely, you can say restrict the or keep watch on the movement, right, of Indian forces into this region, right? So China will keep, you can say, watching the Indian movements, watching the activities of India, right? Watching the, you can say, strength in the Bay of Bengal region, in the, you can say, Arabian region, in the, we can say, Indian Ocean region also, right? So better that will be an important thing, right? So beta, China has one thing is that China has a naval base at present here in the Djibouti. That second thing, China is going to develop a naval base, you can say, in this region also, right? China is going to develop a naval base in Pakistan also here, Gawadar region, right? China is going to do that, right? And the next important thing is the Chinese submarines have already entered into this region, Sri Lanka, Hambantota, right? And Subita, through these points, right, from these points, China can keep watch over the entire Indian Ocean, the movements of anybody into the Indian Ocean region, right? And China can even hunt those, right? Right? And this will definitely affect the, or you can say, put in risk the movements of the Indian forces into the, you can say, Indian Ocean region, right? And beta, one submarine from China, one nuclear submarine from China was already noticed here on the Hambantota port of Sri Lanka. One is that, right? And beta, last year, you can say, in 2019, right? A Chinese, you can say, very modern electronic surveillance ship, you can say, entered into, you can say, Indian Ocean region, right? Entered into this, you can say, Bay of Bengal region, right? Intruded into this, we can say, exclusive economic zone of India on the western side near the Andaman and Nicobar, right? Last year, in China's very advanced and modern, you can say, surveillance ship, okay, electronic surveillance ship, right, intruded into the Bay of Bengal region. Intruded into exclusive economic zone of India in Bay of Bengal region. And stayed there for about 15 days. Stayed there for about 15 days we can say, right? 15 days. Okay, so more such instances have also been noticed there, right? So this, so the purpose of this ship was to assess the, you can say, naval strength of the, you can say, of, you can say, India into this region, right? That what is the naval strength of India into this region? The purpose of this was that to you can say assess that, right? So with this way, you can say this is also another threat to, you can say, India, right? So is it clear beta this point? So one threat is so one threat is antidoting Malacca influence of India, right? And second threat is beta spying surveillance and, you can say, military movements of India, right? And you can say this defense forces movements of India, naval forces movements of India. Second is this point. And the third point is beta India's trade and energy security. Right? Third point is India's trade and energy security. The third point is that. That is also an important issue. Right? India's trade and energy security. Right? Okay. So beta, one thing is here that in July 2020, India has entered into an agreement with this, with, we can say, Iran, okay, as we have already discussed, right? And according to which this, you can say, China, you can say, will develop a port here and two ports there in the Persian Gulf region and free economic zones, free trade zones, etc., etc. That will be done by that, right? Right? And beta, you can say, and one more thing, beta, China has these are the, you can say, secret reports, not you can say confirmed yet, that you can say in this strategic partner between Iran and China, right? Both the countries, you can say, will conduct joint military training and exercises. Both the countries will conduct joint military training and exercises. Military training and exercises. And exercises, one thing is that, right? Second thing is research and weapon development. Research and weapon development. Both the countries will do that also. Research and weapon development. Both the countries will do that also. Research and weapon development and sharing of intelligence also. Sharing of intelligence, right? So it means this is, you can say, military alliance of between the two countries, Iran and China, right? But if these reports are true, then you can say this is a very big threat to the energy security of India. Because India's, you can say, oil supplies to India, right, mostly come from this region, Iran, Saudi Arabia, Iraq, right? So this region, right? So beta, from, you can say, Iraq and this, we can say, Iran, right? There is no other, you can say, route for the energy supplies, right, except from this region, Strait of Hormuz and Arabian Sea and then India. Right, and beta, on the Strait of Hormuz is China, right? China, and here also China. So it means, in case of any, you can say, adverse relationship between India and China, in that case, China is becoming in position to block the energy supply of India. Right, and the second route is this beta via Red Sea, okay, from this, you can say, Saudi Arabia via Red Sea, and beta, again, China is sitting here, right? So it means there is a very big threat to the energy security of India in future, right? So this is there, right? So beta, and the next thing is that beta, the you can say, almost entire maritime trade of India, entire maritime trade of India, you can say, with the Europe, Eastern America, and Northern Africa, right, is through this region, Indian Ocean, Red Sea, Suez Canal, and Mediterranean Sea, and then Atlantic Ocean, right? So, beta, again here at the choke points, China is sitting. Right, China is here, China is here. Right, so it means China can block India's trade also. China can affect India's trade also. So, beta, it means China is gaining strategical advantage over India in, you can say, all respects. All respects means, number one, China is increasing its, we can say, influence over almost all neighbors of India. Pakistan is there, Bangladesh is there, Myanmar is there, Nepal is there, right? Sri Lanka is there, Maldives is there, right? Almost all neighbors of India. One point is that, and China is not having cordial relationship with India. We are having the territorial disputes pending. We have fought a war also, and the border skirmishes are also common between India and China. So this is the next point, right? And increasing association between China and Pakistan. With Pakistan also, India doesn't have the cordial relations. So this is there, right? And beta, one point is that, right? And the next point is that Indian Ocean is the, we can say, growth engine of the, we can say, Indian economy, because the entire energy supplies and the entire trade of India passes through the Indian Ocean region, right? And beta, both ways. On the western side of India, China is making its influence through the Gwadar port and through this Maldives port, right? And on the southern side of India, Maldives port, and again this this Sambandota port. On the eastern side, again beta, this Chittagong, Kyokshu, and Koko Island, right? And again influence, right? So beta, it means there is very big threat to, you can say, India from China, right? From its string of pearls policy, particularly, right? And the second is beta, surveillance and spying into the Indian Ocean regions, right? Chinese submarines have already been noticed, right? And Chinese surveillance ships have already been noticed into the exclusive economic zone of India for spying purposes. So beta, that is why we can see that intentions of China are not clear. One thing is that, right? So India has, you can say, major threats from China in the days to come. Okay, from particularly its, you can say, string of pearls policy. This is the second point. And the third is to conclude, we can say that, right? India has to do, number one, right, what India can do in this situation. Number one, India should improve its strategic alliances with various other countries, like India has done it with the US, Japan, and you can say Australia. The group of the four countries is known as the Quad, right? So India has conducted the joint military exercises with, you can say, Japan also, with US also, with, you can say, Singapore also. Right, and in the similar manner, India should increase its, you can say, influence over its neighbor countries. Right, India should not allow its, you can say, neighbor countries to move too much towards, you can say, China. Right, India should be cordial with its all neighbor nations. Though we can say that is India's policy, India remains always cordial with the neighbors. But still, India needs to focus more on that, right? India needs to focus, you can say, with more practical approach on the, you can say, Act India policy, right? Which was the Look India policy when it was launched during the Prime Minister Narasimha Rao times. So that is important. That is the second thing which is important. Though we can say India is doing all the possible efforts, right? But still, India needs to be more energetic, right? And better seeing the strategical disadvantage of India from the string of pearls policy, seeing the, you can say, small size of India's economy as compared with the Chinese economy, and seeing the growing, you can say, political clout of China with other nations like Pakistan, Iran, Sudan, right, and Myanmar, all these things, all these countries, right? So, beta, India should try to resolve its pending territorial disputes with China, right, as early as possible, because the longer we, you can say, carry on these, you can say, disputes, those may become, you can say, costly for India in the days to come, seeing the China's grip, China's hold, which is becoming, you can say, tighter nowadays, right? And India has been, you can say, cordoned off from, you can say, all the sides. So that is why India needs to move very strategically, right? And on the one side, India needs to, you can say harness its, we can say, alliances with the various, countries of the world, right? And at the same time, India should try to resolve its pending disputes with China, right? So that is the that is what we can write in the conclusion at the end, right? So no doubt, this is a very big threat for India. So beta, is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any this any you can say doubt of anybody, you can please ask me. Any doubt of anybody? See, I have explained it in a very logical manner, right? If I want to, you can say, sum it up with you, right? If I want to revise the important points, right? So one is the string of pearls policy. I think that is clear to you, that what is the string of pearls policy of China. Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. And second beta, India's threats, right? As far as the India's threats is concerned, we have taken, you can say, 3 points only. One is the Malacca dilemma of China, right? In that context, we have discussed. And the second context is, which we have discussed, that is a surveillance, right? Surveillance and spying and defense forces movement. And Indian forces movement, we can say. The second point is this, which we have taken into account, which we have discussed here, Indian forces movement. And the third important point, which we have discussed, is that threat to India's energy security and trade. Threat to India's energy security and trade, right? So with the energy security and trade, right? And the Indian Ocean is the growth engine of Indian economy, so we cannot afford that. Right, and right, and with the in conclusion I told you that you must have to mention that right, Chinese grip is increasing, right? Chinese grip is becoming more firm in the Indian Ocean region. Right, and in that context, India has three options. India people ten options, right? In that context, beta, India has three options. Right, India has three options. Right, one option is increase its strengths. Okay, increase its strengths in parallel with China. Right, this is the one option. Perhaps this would not be possible for India. Second, enter into strategic alliances with other countries, which India is to some extent doing. right? Strategic alliances and military partnerships with other countries, right? And the third option before India is to resolve of the dispute with India, disputes with China, cordially, right? Cordially and as early as possible, as soon as possible, right? Because if we still prolong it, we may have to bear the cost of that, right? Because so, because through this string of power, so China is going to even compensate in case any trade loss from India occurs to China, right? Because China will compensate that from Pakistan, from Iran, from Iraq, right? From other countries of the world, and China, no need to depend even for trade on India also. So that is the main thing, right? And the growing association of China, growing association of India and Pakistan also, you can say, is not favor of, you can say, India, I think, because in that case also, right, you know, the, in case the enmity between in China and US increases, in that case also, you can say, India may have to take, you can say, one side clearly, and that is obviously India will go with the US, and that is also not in the interest of India, according to me. Right? So because this is the whole thing. Right? If anybody wants...
Excuse me, sir. Yes. Sir, please shift all these points on the plain screen.
Plain screen, but I can try if it is possible, but because I think...
Sir, or on the light area, on this C area, you can put...
better, because copy is not possible now from here. I will have to,
sir, only you back. Can shift on the little left, you can shift
little left, I can shift, but little left also there is the, you can see other, the color is
okay, sir, here it is, okay.
black, right, you can note it from here.
Yes, sir, okay, now it's okay, sir. Okay. Yes, thank you, sir.
Okay, Vita. So I should suppose that nobody has any doubt.
Well, these particular things can be quoted in the GS3 internal security as well, I guess.
Yes, obviously.
Yes, sir. These all things are very important for GS3 point of view.
Yes. Okay. So I hope this is clear to you.
Yes, sir. It's very much clear.
Yes, sir.
So, you have to decode, you can say, every topic in this manner, right? And once you decode every topic in this manner, in that case, it will become, you can say, easier for you to, you can say, solve anything, right? Or you can say, address any question in a more organized manner, yeah? Right? So, beta, I expect from you, by tomorrow, you will write the answer of this question from the UPSC point of view, right? Not more than in 200 words. Right? Because I have explained too much here. Right, Bita?
So, Bita, yes, sir.
Right. So, Bita, I would like right, that if you write this, you can say answer, right? So, Bita, and this is my, you can save the phone number, you all know, right? So 5060, that number is with everybody, with everybody there. So beta, if you will write the answer, send me at this number via, you can say, WhatsApp, right? And and beta, after that, right, send me this at via WhatsApp, right? So beta, after that, those persons who will send me their answers via this WhatsApp, I can provide them the model answer also of this question, right? But only after seeing your answers, right? I can provide model answer. So it means a far model answer if you want, right? So then you must have to write the answer and send me it on the WhatsApp. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, okay, sir.
Okay, beta. So this was about